interruptus, do you? I'd have to do me so long to find you. Did you really think you could hide from me? I will always find you. You're a piece of me. And if you scream, or if you call for help, I will kill you. Do you understand? Okay.
Where's my child?
Jason.
You're what?
I lost the baby.
I'm gonna know that's a fucking lie. So I'm gonna ask you again. Where is my child?
Gone.
Is there a problem here?
No, just checking up on a friend.
I think it's time for you to go. Our friend needs to rest.
True, true.
You're home early.
Yeah. I got fired.
What? Why?
Yeah. Oh, Bobby thought I was stealing from the company, which is bullshit.
Of course it is. Are you hungry?
I'm starving. What do you got?
You know, I could go back to work. Help with the bills.
What? What are you gonna do? You didn't even finish your GED. Oh, man. Food.
Right. I could order from that Chinese food place that you like. I didn't get a chance to go out and buy groceries.
Why?
I haven't been feeling well.
Really? You look sick.
What, are you a doctor now?
Who the hell do you think you're talking to? I've had the shittiest day! You're gonna talk crap to me like that? Who the fuck do you think you're talking to, bitch?
I'm pregnant! Please don't.
What? What? Oh, you are screwed now, bitch. Oh, shit. Oh, it just gets better and better. Oh, my God. You are so screwed. I love kids.
So I never looked back. I had no money. I had no friends. I had no family. Couldn't get a job. I knew Jason would find me. I knew I had to leave town. I had to start a new life. I had to find a new identity for my son to have some sort of life. So I picked a profession where anonymity was number one. No more Joanne Edwards. And now he's found me.
It's been 10 years. How'd he find you after all this time?
You tell me.
Alexis, I swear to you, we had nothing to do with this.
As a matter of fact, I had no idea about your past with Jason.
Well, somebody did, and someone tipped him off, and I can only think of one person right now.
If it were me, don't you think I would have led him straight to your son? He has no idea where he is. That's why he went to you first.
I have to find out who did this.
I agree. You made sure you weren't followed on your way here, right?
Of course.
Jason's very resourceful. Don't underestimate him.
Let's place a detail around the community. I want them to be discreet, but not invisible. That way, if he shows up, he's gonna know we mean business.
Cool. I'm on it.
That's a great idea.
I learned from the best. In the meantime, why don't you stay here while you recover?
I was planning on it.
Good. Why didn't you kill him that night when you had the chance?
I loved him.
And now?
I love my son more.
It was a funeral. How do you think it was?
Was Sean okay?
Do I really need to answer that right now? I mean, he did just bury his husband.
Just talk to me, Mo. Don't shut me out. Please.
I really don't want to talk to you right now. I don't even know who you are anymore.
Mo, I'm your wife.
No, you're not. Because the woman that I married would never be involved in this shit. People are dead, Jennifer. Dead. And you're right smack in the middle of it.
I didn't know what Brother Ray was going to do.
Of course not. I mean, why would you? When you were so busy running around sticking your nose in everyone else's business. I mean, you turned a blind eye to what was unraveling right there in front of you.
It's not my fault.
Yeah. You just keep telling yourself that. And you may even start believing it yourself.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
I'm going to sleep in the guest room. I can't stand to be around you right now.
Mo, please, please. Stay and talk to me. I need you. I need my husband.
Get off me.
Mo, wait. I'm a victim too.
Where did Scott go?
He took my aunt to the airport.
And is Sean still asleep?
I think so.
Good. He needed some rest. Are you okay?
Yeah. It's just been a really long day.
Tell me about it. Hey, I overheard Scott talking to your mom on the phone. Your father hasn't been home in a few days or something. Is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm sure it is.
He's probably just lying low somewhere.
Listen, I heard about what he did. Are you ever gonna tell your mom about what he did to you, Selena? She needs to know.
You know, if I thought that she would be able to receive it, I would. But some things are just better left unsaid, and you gotta leave it up to karma.
Karma doesn't always work fast enough.
Sometimes it's faster than you think.
What are you doing in here? Who are you?
Well, who the hell are you?
I live here.
This is my house. Where's my cousin Melissa?
You're lying. My girlfriend's cousin is dead.
Well, think again, Jethro.
It is you.
Well, what the hell are you standing there looking so stupid for? Call my cousin and tell her to get home now. And give me some goddamn chips.
Need some help?
Nope. I'm almost done. Just a few more dishes.
Everybody gone?
Yeah. Your mom said to give her a call when you got up, and Julian's parents went back to the hotel. I saved you a plate of food. You're hungry?
No. I don't have appetite. We've been here for this. I keep thinking it'd be different, but it's not. I just want... I keep thinking any minute he's gonna walk through that door. But he's not.
I miss him so much.
friend no, honey.
It's me. We have a problem. He's escaped.
I just got through several funerals. One for my best friend's husband, one for my cousin LaShawn, and I am in no mood for this right now.
I'll make it quick.
I don't need to keep your voice down. Scott is sleeping right upstairs.
What are you doing?
Tell him anything.
Good, then keep it that way.
Nancy, you have no control over my life. What I decide to tell my husband is my business.
When it affects me, it is.
Listen to you. Do you have any remorse for what we did? Any?
Your father have any when he was sneaking in your room and raping you?
You need to get the hell out of my house, Nancy.
Not going anywhere until you assure me that you're not going to say anything to Scott.
Please.
Tell Scott what?
Hey, honey. I thought you were sleeping.
I was. But what is she doing here?
I came by to talk to Selena about an organization that I thought our event planning company would do good with.
And I was just telling Nancy that now's not really a good time for me.
Well, I tried. Maybe next time.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and show myself up.
Oh, wait, Nancy. So, what didn't you want Selena to tell me?
I'm
pregnant! Yeah.
What?
I'm pregnant.
We're gonna have a baby.
Baby.
We're gonna have a baby.
Yes.
See, that's what we were talking about before. I overheard Selena on the phone with her doctor the other day, and I told her I didn't want you to know that I knew before you.
Well, thank you. That was very thoughtful of you.
You have no idea. Ah, well, gonna let you two celebrate. Congratulations again.
Thank you. Have a good night.
So I sent her out, and when I went to go pick her up, I found her like this.
You
dumbass. Didn't you vet the client first?
Man, he's paying triple the rate, man. I wasn't about to turn that money down.
You're an idiot. He's an idiot.
Okay, you two, shut up. What is that in her pocket?
I want him dead.
Hey. Scott. Come on, I'm not playing with you. If you jump out of those covers and you scare me, I'm being serious.
My God! No, no, no. No, Scott!